إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. All praise is due to Allah. We praise Him a praise that's suitable for His loftiness and His greatness and His supremacy. And we bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He's one, alone, and unique. He has no partners. He has no associates. And we bear witness that Muhammad is His servant and His messenger. All you who believe, know the importance and the fadl and the ni'mah of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored us, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen us, and He has made distinguishing factors in this religion. It's important for every Muslim to be aware of these distinguishing factors. And from these distinguishing factors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this religion, a clear mark for it is that the Muslim and the believer is constantly contemplating about meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meeting the one who created him from nothing, meeting Allah. And this is when he dies and he returns to Allah. And the Muslims are always contemplating upon death. For verily death, it keeps the Muslim focused and keeps him and pushes him to be steadfast and pulls him away from disobedience to Allah. Na'am, ja'a inda tabarani min hadithi sahal ibn sa'adin anna jibreel قال يا محمد إش ما شئت فإنك ميت. Where it comes in al-Tabarani from the hadith of Sahih ibn Sa'an, that Jibreel, the angel, he said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O Muhammad, live as long as you want to live, but verily you're going to die. إعمل ما شئت فإنك مجزي بي. Do whatever you want from these, because verily you're going to be held accountable to it, and you're going to be rewarded according to it. أحبب من شئت فإنك مفارق. Love whoever you want to love, for verily you're going to part from him. This is the reality of death. And alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes this reality clear to us. Ayyuhal mu'min, my dear brother in Islam, the righteous before us, they used to contemplate upon death all the time, and this would aid them to remain steadfast and desire to meet Allah upon obedience to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذْكُرْ عِبَادَنَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ أُولِي الْأَيْدِي وَالْأَبْصَارِ. Remember our servants, Ibrahim, وإسحاق وَيَعْقُوب. They were people of good deeds, and they were people who had intelligence and had knowledge. إِنَّا أَخْلَصْنَاهُمْ بِخَالِصَةٍ ذِكْرَ الدَّارِ. Verily, we chose them for a particular quality. They would always remember the hereafter. Na'am, because in remembering the hereafter, and remembering the day that you're going to meet Allah, this is going to aid you in your religion, my dear brother in Islam. When Nabiyyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana yaqul, Allahumma la aisha illa aishul akhirah, faghfir lil ansari wal muhajirah. Oh Allah, there is no life except the life in the hereafter. Therefore, forgive his companions from amongst the muhajirin and ansar. Na'am ya ibadallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord and our Creator, He guides us to this reality and reminds us that we need to meet Allah upon submission and upon obedience to Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, ittaqu allaha haqqa tuqatihi wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. All you who believe, fear Allah as He ought to be feared, and don't die except that you're in a state of submission. Don't die except you're in a state of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he who strives to die upon obedience, this necessitates that he lives upon obedience. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you tawfiq. Na'am ya ibadallah. Faqad qala nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as it comes from the hadith of Abi Hurairah, our Prophet said, Al-akthiru dhikra hadhi min ladhat, ya'ni al-maut. Mention in abundance, frequently mention
that which destroys all the joy and the pleasures of this world, meaning death. Na'am, because it helps you keep your eyes on the prize. It helps you remain steadfast. Na'am, ya ibadallah. Rarely, in reminding and remembering about death is a ni'mah and is barakah. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls us to. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, ittaqullah wal tanzur nafsun ma qaddamat lighad. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. O you who believe, fear Allah, and let every individual look to what he put forward for tomorrow. Look at the deeds that he prepared for the hereafter, and then fear Allah. Really, Allah is well aware of what you do. Na'am, ya Abdullah, you are in need of good deeds. Na'am, you're going to meet your Lord. And the day that a mu'min meets his Lord, hani Allah, congratulations to him. Na'am ya ibadullah. When Nabiyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, as it comes from the hadith of Anas ibn Malik, yatba'ul mayyit thalath, three things, they follow the dead person to his grave. Ahluhu wa maluhu wa amaluhu, his family and his wealth and his good deeds, or his deeds, whether they're good or bad. Fayarji ithnani wa yabqa wahid, two things come back and one thing remains with him in his grave. يَرْجِعُ أَهْلُهُ وَمَالُهُ, his money and his family return back from the graveyard. وَيَبْقَى عَمَلُهُ, and his deeds remain with him. نَعَمْ يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ. تَذَكَّرُوا هَذَا, remember this, contemplate upon this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, and that the mu'min, when he meets Allah, this is a great day for him if he's upon obedience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ كَانُوا يَرُجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهُ, whoever is desiring to meet his Lord. And that's you, Abdullah. That's you. You're the one desiring to meet your Lord. You're looking forward for that day to meet the one who created you, because you prayed to him and you gave sadaqah for his sake and you made hajj for his sake and you made tawbah only for his sake. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرُجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّي, whoever is looking for that day and learning for that day when he meets his Lord, فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا, then let him do good deeds. وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا, and don't let him worship other than Allah. نَعْمْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ, for keeping your eyes on the prize and staying focused. This is what death reminds you about. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَهْوٌ وَلَعَبٌ, what is the life of this world except entertainment and play? وَإِنَّ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانِ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ, and verily the hereafter, this is the real life if they only knew. نَعَمْ يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the disbelievers and how they regret when they die. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises them up, they regret that they didn't have one thing. They don't want to get more money. They don't want to get more time, but they want to get more deeds. They want to earn some deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ, that day when the hellfire is brought close. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ وَأَنَّا لَهُ الذِّكْرَى, that day, mankind, the disbelievers, they contemplate about their hal, about their situation. وَأَنَّا لَهُ الذِّكْرَى, but contemplating now is not going to benefit him. The time is too late. The time now is to contemplate now. يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِي, he says, if only I'd have done something from good deeds for my life, my real life in the hereafter. نَعَمْ يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains their hal, explains their situation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذِ الْمُجْرِمُونَ نَاكِسُوا رُؤُوسِهِمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ, and if you could see the disbelievers, the criminals, standing before Allah on the Day of Judgment with their heads down in humiliation, يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا أَبْصَرْنَا وَسَمِعْنَا, they say, oh our Lord, we see now, everything is clear, we hear, فَرْجِعْنَا نَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا, send us back to the world so we could do some good deeds. إِنَّا مُوقِنُونَ, now we clearly believe, but the time is too late for them. Ya Abdullah, take the opportunity now and do good deeds. You are in dire need for deeds. Na'am ya Abdullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, describing the situation of the disbelievers, فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتُ قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِيمَا تَرَكْتُ. And when death comes to one of them, they say, oh my Lord, have them take me back, meaning back to the life of this world. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا, so that perhaps I could do some good deeds. فِيمَا تَرَكْتُ, in the things that I left, in the things that I neglected. كَلَّا إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ هُوَ قَائِلُهَا. Allah says, no way. Really, this is something on a statement on their tongues that they wish. وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. And in front of them is going to be barzakh, the grave, until the day that they are brought up from their graves. نَعْمْ يَا عِبَادُ اللَّهِ. Know, my dear brothers in Islam, that which you understand from death, from sorrow and grief and sadness, that's only for the ones that are still living, the ones that part from the one that deceased. But the one that's deceased and the one that has died, akramahullah, if he's on ibadah, Allah has honored him. The day that a Muslim dies, the day that the believer dies, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala akramah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored him. Mautul mu'min karamah, the death of a believer, the death of somebody who's obedient, it's an honorable day. It's an honorable thing. Hey, wallah, don't you have any doubt in your mind about that? Your deeds is going to bring you the reward of Allah immediately. When Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, as it comes from the hadith of Abi Umama, man qara'a ayatul kursi dubra kulli salatin maktuba. Whoever reads ayatul kursi at the end of every salat, that's wajib on him. لَمْ يَمْنَعْهُ مِنْ دُخُولِ الْجَنَّةِ إِلَّا أَنْ يَمُوتِ. Nothing prevents him from entering into Jannah except that he dies. نَعَمْ نَسَمَةُ الْمُؤْمِنْ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. The ruh in the soul of a mu'min is in Jannah. When a man dies, he's in Jannah. Even if his body is in the grave, but his ruh is in Jannah. نَعَمْ يَا عِبَادُ اللَّهِ. وَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى says, describing how the believer is when the malaika come down. We want to understand and make it clear that all the sadness and all the grief, that's only for the ones remaining, parting from their loved one. As for that one who has died, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described. الَّذِينَ تَتَوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ طَيِّبِينَ يَقُولُونَ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ فَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. The ones that the malaika that come down to snatch his soul, and he's upon goodness, طيبين, he's upon righteousness. They say to him, Salamun alaykum, peace be upon you, udukhulu al-jannah, enter Jannah because of what you used to do, because of your righteous needs, not because of your name, not because of your job, not because of your nationality, not because of your money, but because of your righteous deeds. Na'am ya Abdullah, barakallahu feek. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in ayat, in verses of the Quran that we're all familiar with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyatuha nafsu al-mutma'inna. When the malaika come down, they call him, oh, you soul that is pure and that's in tranquil, that is tayyib. Irji'i ila rabbiki radiyatan marubiyya. Come, return to your Lord and you're pleased, and you're pleased with. Fadukhuli fi ibadi wadukhuli jannati. Enter upon my servants in righteousness. Enter into my Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further describes the situation clearly for us. So we'll be about contentment and tuma'nina wal qana'ah. And we'll be totally content with this matter. Inna alladhina qalu rabbuna Allahu thumma istaqamu. Really, those who say, we believe in Allah, and they're upon steadfastness, tatanazzalu alayhimu al-malaika. The malaika, they come down to snatch their soul. The malaika say to them, an la takhafu wa la tahzanu. Don't be afraid and don't despair and don't cry and don't be sad. Don't be afraid and don't be afraid of where you're going, not which is in front of you. Don't have any fear. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. And don't be sad and don't cry. Don't be crying. Don't cry and be sad of what you're going to part. They are in comfort and they are in raha. وَمَوْتُ الْمُؤْمِنْ كَرَامَةً. The death of a believer is an honor. Allah has honored him the day that he took his soul when he was upon obedience to Allah. When Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, as it comes from the hadith of Aisha wa Anas, it also comes from Ubad ibn Usama wa Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called, Man ahabba liqa'a Allah, ahabba Allahu liqa'a. Whoever loves to meet Allah, Allah loves to meet him. Wa man kariha liqa'a Allah, kariha Allahu liqa'a. Whoever dislikes to meet Allah, Allah dislikes to meet him. قالت عائشة يا نبي الله أكراهية الموت فكل لا نكره الموت. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, O Messenger of Allah, are you speaking about the disliking of death? For really all of us dislike death. قَالَ لَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ. The Prophet said, it's not like that. وَلَكِنْ الْعَبْدِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِذَا بُشِّرَ بِمَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانَهُ أَحَبَّ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ فَأَحَبَّ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَهُ. But the believer, when he's dying, and he gets the good news of the mercy of Allah and his forgiveness and the pleasure of Allah, he desires to meet Allah, and Allah desires to meet him. وَالْكَافِرْ إِذَا بُشِرَ بِعَذَابِ اللَّهِ وَسَخَتِهِ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ فَكَرِهَ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَ. And the disbeliever, if he gets the news of the punishment of Allah when he's on his deathbed, and the malaika tell him of the anger of Allah, he hates to meet Allah, and Allah hates to meet him. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his mercy and success.
الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضاه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. عباد الله, don't be distracted by the life of this world. Remember Allah. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created for one purpose, and that's that you worship Him, and that which that you obey Him. He has given you your very life. He has given you your eyesight, taste on your tongue, the smell in your nose. People have legs and can't walk. You can walk. People have eyes and can't see, but you can see. And you pay no money for that. هُوَ تَفَضُّلًا مِنْ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it for him. You didn't deserve it. He didn't owe it for you. But it's a pure ni'mah from Allah for you to die upon obedience to Allah. قَدْ أَكْرَمَكَ اللَّهِ. Allah has honored you. نَعَمْ إِوَاللَّهِ. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a detailed description, had described to us how the believer dies when the angels take their death. It comes in the Imam Ahmed from Hadith Bara ibn Azam, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ata janazatan lil rajul min al ansar, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to a janazah from a man from amongst the ansar, from amongst his companions, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, innal abd al mu'min إذا كان في انقطاع من الدنيا وإقبال من الآخرة. That is the believer, if he is parting from this world and he's entering upon the hereafter, meaning he's dying, نزلت عليه ملائكة بيض الوجوه. The malaika, they come down to him. They have white faces. كَأَنَّ وُجُوهُهُمُ الشَّمْسِ. As if their faces was the sun. That's how bright it is. وَلَهُمْ كَفَنٌ مِنْ أَكْفَانِ الْجَنَّةِ. And they have a shroud in the kafan from the kafan of Jannah. وَحَنُوتٌ مِنْ حَنُوتِ الْجَنَّةِ. And they have fragrances and perfumes from the fragrances of Jannah. فَيَجْلِسُ مِنْهُ مَدَّ الْبَصَرِ. And they sit close to him as far as the eye can see. ثُمَّ يَجِئُ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَجْلِسُ عِنْدَ رَأْسِ. And then the angel comes down, the angel of death, come down, and it sits at his head. وَيَقُولُ أُخْرُجِي يَقُولُ أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةُ أُخْرُجِي إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانَهُ. And the angel of death says to the soul, oh, you soul that is tayyib, come out to the mercy of Allah, and to the pleasure of Allah, and to the forgiveness of Allah. فَإِذَا خَرَجَ إِذَا خَرَجَ تَسِيلُ كَمَا تَسِيلُ قَطْرَةُ مِنْ فِي السِّمَاءِ مِنْ فِي السِّقَاءِ. When the soul comes out, it comes out just like a drop of water comes out of a bottle of water. نعم يا عباد الله. فَيَأْخُذَهَا فَإِذَا أَخَذَهَا لَمْ يَدْعُوهَا فِي يَدِهَا طَرْفَةَ عَيْنٍ. If the angel of death takes the soul, the other angels don't leave the soul in his hand for the blink of an eye. حَتَّى يَأْخُذُوهَا فَيَجْعُلُهَا فِي ذَٰلِكَ الْكَفِنْ وَفِي ذَٰلِكَ الْحَانُوتِ. Until they take it and they put it and they shroud it, and that kafan that's from Jannah, and they shroud it and they put that perfume in it, and that perfume that is from Jannah, and they shroud it in that perfume. فَتَخْرُجُ مِنْهُ كَأَطْيَبِ نَفْخَةِ مِسْكٍ وُجِدَ الْأَرْضُ. And it comes from it a scent that's the best scent that was ever smelt in this whole earth. نعم. فَيَسْعَدُونَ بِهَا فَكُلَّمَا يَمُرُّ بِهَا عَلَى مَلَئٍ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Then they go up with this soul, the soul of the believer. They go up with it to the sky. And every time they pass by it,
past a group of malaika, yaqulun man hadha ar-ruh at-tayyib. They say, what is this good soul? Yaqulun hadha fulan ibn fulan bi ahsani asma' kan yusammunahu biha fid dunya. They say, this is fulan, the son of fulan, with the best of the names he was ever named with in the life of this world. فَيُشَيِّعُهُ الْمَلَائِكَ مِنْ كُلِّ سَمَاءٍ فَيَسْعَدُونَ بِهِ إِلَى سَمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. Then the malaika, they take him up to the sky that's here, right above this world here. فَيَسْتَفْتِحُونَ فَيُفْتَحْ لَهُ. They request that the sky is open, the sky is open for him. فَيُشَيِّعُهُ مِنْ كُلِّ سَمَاءٍ مُقَرِّبُوهَا. Then the malaika, in that sky, they follow him in a procession until the sky that comes after it. حَتَّى يُنْتَهَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ السَّابِعَةِ. Until he ends in the highest sky, in the seventh sky. يَقُولُ اللَّهُ اُكْتُبْ كِتَابَ عَبْدِي فِي الْعِلِّيِّينَ. Write the deeds of my servant. Write his deeds in the highest part of Jannah. ثُمَّ عَيْدُهُ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ. Send him back down to the ground. مِنْهَا خَلَقْتُهُمْ وَمِنْهَا وَفِيهَا أُعِيدُهُمْ وَمِنْهَا أُخْرِجُهُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. From the land I created them, and in it I will return them, and from it I will bring them out one more time. فَيُعَادُ الرُّوحُ فِي جَسَدِي. Then his soul is set back down into his body. فَيَأْتِيهِ مَلَكَانِ فَيُجْلِسَانِ. Two angels, they come to him, and they sit him up in his grave. فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ مَنْ رَبُّكَ. And they say to him, who is your Lord? يَقُولُ رَبِّي اللَّهِ. He says, my Lord is Allah. يَقُولُ مَا دِينُكَ. They say to him, what is your religion? يَقُولُ دِينِي الْإِسْلَامِ. He says, my religion in Islam. يَقُولُ مَنْ هَذَا الرَّجُلُ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ. Who is this man that was sent to you? يَقُولُ هُوَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. He said, he's the messenger of Allah. قَالُوا قَالَ مَا عِلْمُكَ بِي. They say, how do you know this? يَقُولُ, he says, أنا قرأت كتاب الله وآمنت به وصدقت. He said, I read the book of Allah and I believed in it and I confirmed it. فَيُنَادِي مُدَادٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ. Somebody's going to call out from the sky. أن صدق عبدي. Now my servant has spoke the truth. فَأَفْرِشُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ. Furnish him from Jannah. وَأَلْبِسُوهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ. And give him the clothes of Jannah. وَافْتَحُوا لَهُ بَابًا مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ. And open up for him a gate that goes to Jannah. فَيَأْتِيهِ طِيبُهَا وَرَوْحِهَا. And good scents and good smells come to him. فَيَأْتِيهِ رَجُلٌ حَسُنُ الْوَجْهِ حَسُنُ الثِّيَابِ طَيِّبُ الرِّيحِ. A man comes to him with a beautiful face while he's in his grave. A man comes to him with a beautiful face, with beautiful clothing, smelling good. فَيَقُولُ أَبْشِرْ بِمَا يَسُرُّكَ. And this man says to him, أَبْشِرْ, I give you the good news of everything that brings you joy. قَلْ مَنْ أَنْتَ وَجْحُكَ وَجْحَ الَّذِي يُبَشِّرُ بِخَيْرٍ. He said, who are you? Your face is the face that only informs about good. يَقُولُ أَنَا عَمَلُكَ صَالِحٌ. I'm your good deeds. I'm your salah. I'm your zakah, I'm your siyam, I'm your fasting, I'm the footsteps that you take to the masjid, I'm your fasting, I'm all your good deeds, I'm your repentance. فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَقِمِ السَّاعَةَ رَبِّي أَقِمِ السَّاعَةَ حَتَّى أَرْجِ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ وَمَالِي. Allah, bring on the hour. Allah, bring on the qiyamah, so I can get from my reward and go back to my family and my wealth. Ya ibadallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored the believers the day that they meet him and upon obedience. Stay upon obedience. Remember death, the day that you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For verily, it keeps you focused and it keeps you steadfast. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his aid. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his forgiveness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for steadfastness. Innahu waliyu dhalika wal qadir alayh. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.